Good evening, everybody. Welcome to our show. Say hi to my band, why don't you? There they are.
Tonight you're mine completely, and you give your love so sweetly. Tonight the light of love is in your eyes, but will you love me tomorrow? Said I need. Treasure, is it just one moment's pleasure? Can I believe the magic that I see in your eyes? Will you still love me tomorrow? Again, will you still love me? Will you still love me? Will you still love me? Will you love me, baby? Will you love me? Will you love me tomorrow? Will you love me tomorrow?
Yeah. Phil Whitfall. I'd like to start the show with one of the highlights of the show, in case you have to leave early. I'd like to do a medley of my hits. So I want to sing it for you, okay? Before I do, this is a little frightening. This is me in, 1970. It is frightening, isn't it? It's like a helmet I used to have. So that was me then. Here's the song, 1974. I hope you guys remember. Somebody will remember. We'll see. Here we go.
My name is Michael. I got a nickel. I got a nickel shiny in you. I'm gonna buy me all kinds of candy. That's what I'm gonna do. You remember it? When this world gets me down and there's no love to be found, I close my eyes and soon I find I'm in a playground of my mind where the children laugh and the children play, and we sing a song all day. My name is Michael. I got a nickel. Said I got a nickel, shiny and new. I'm gonna buy me all kinds of candy. That's what I'm gonna do.
Whoa, the wonders that I find in the playground in my mind, in a world
world that used to be. Close your eyes and follow me to where the children laugh and the children play, and we sing a song all day. Sing it with me, ladies. Here we go.
My girl is Cindy.
When we get married, we're gonna have a baby or two. We're gonna let them visit their grandma. That's what we're gonna do. Let me teach you the words. Ba 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 ba. Second verse. Ba 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 ba. You get the idea, right? Ba 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 ba. Sing along if you like.
Ba ba ba.
Sing, little children. Thank you. I drink a toast to music and the way it makes us feel. Cheers. Cheers. I knew a man, Bojangles, and he would dance for you. In worn-out shoes, silver hair, ragged shirt, baggy pants. He'd do the old soft shoe. Y'all know who I'm singing about, right? Who? Sammy. Sammy Davis Jr. The best who ever did this. Very lucky in my life, he was my friend. I think about him a lot lately. I grew up in a very small town outside of Buffalo, New York. Literally, Angola, right? 450 people, right, in the town, right? Okay, and on Sunday nights, as a family, we would always watch the Ed Sullivan Show, right? And every time Sammy was on, it was almost like a holiday. We would gather around, and when I think about that, and that I grew up to know him, it's a miracle, man. And not only know him, but he was a friend, and he taught me, he was a mentor of mine. He spent time with me, cared about me. And I think about him, as I said, often in my clearest memory, and Sammy could literally do anything on a stage, but my clearest memory is the way he tap danced. Sammy never went to school a day in his life, not a day. At 4 years old, he was out touring with his uncle and his dad. So everything Sammy Davis learned, he learned on stage. How to talk to people, how to care about people, how to make people care about him, how to make women fall in love with him. He learned it all here. He lived here on stage, which is, of course, why he was so incredibly great as an entertainer. Made it tough in the real world, though. That's where it was a challenge for Sam. In 1960, he married My Britt. My Britt was a beautiful Swedish actress, had a big career going, but when she married Sammy, she didn't want the career. She wanted Sammy. She wanted a family. They had a daughter named Tracy, and there they were in Los Angeles. Problem was, Sammy wasn't there. Sammy was out. Sammy was out with the audience. Sammy was out with the Rat Pack. Sammy was out with the hangers-on. Sammy was out, man. They never saw him. And My Britt came to him, and she said, "Sammy, we love you. Tracy loves you, but we never see you. What are we going to do?" And Sammy said, "I know you're right. I tell you what," he was on his way to Broadway to do a show called Golden Boy. He said, "Come with me, bring Tracy. We'll live in New York, it'll be easier. We'll be at the theater at night, but in the daytime we'll be a family. We'll do all family stuff, right?" So they leave LA, they go to New York, Sammy opens on Broadway, Golden Boy is a smash, and everybody in New York wants him.
They want a piece of him, you know? They want him at the parties, at the charities, at the... You know, Sammy couldn't resist it. It didn't get better. It got worse. So now she came to him. And she said, okay, look. We came here on a promise. And that promise has been broken. What do we do now? And Sammy made a huge choice in his life. He said, this is who you married. I just don't know how to do it any other way. Maybe you'd be happier back in Los Angeles. She took Tracy. They went back to LA. 3 weeks later, she filed for divorce, marriage over, family over. And when Sammy talked about it, he said, as he watched that limousine take his family to the airport and literally out of his life, it was as if his own song began to haunt him. What kind of fool am I who never fell in love? It seems that I'm the only one that I have been thinking of. What kind of man is this? An empty shell, a lonely cell, in which an empty heart must dwell. What kind of clown am I? What do I know of life? Why can't I cast away this mask of play and live my life? Why can't I fall in love like any other man? Maybe then I will know what kind of fool I am. What kind of lips are these that lied with every kiss, that whispered empty words of love, that left me alone like this? What kind of eyes are these that could not see? What could be seen by everybody else but me? What kind of clown am I? What do I know of life? Why can't I cast away this mask of play and live my life? Why can't Harry Belafonte, put me on your shoulders. Harry Belafonte, let me see the view. Harry Belafonte, put me on your shoulders and take me, take me,
Take me across the sea with you. Let me see what the people do. Take me across the sea with you. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ronnie Foster. Together, find out which one is smarter. Some say men, I say no. The woman's smarter, and you should know, not me. Oh, but the people, they say the man leading the woman astray. I say the woman of today smarter than the man in every way.
That's right, the woman is smarter. That's right, the woman is smarter. That's right, the woman is smarter. That's right.
All right.
That's right.
Tell them, girls.
The woman is smarter, that's right. The woman is smarter, that's right.
The woman is smarter, that's right.
You know that that's right.
I kept the money hidden in my bed, in a pillow beneath my head. Oh Lord, she took the money, run to Venezuela.
Oh Lord, Matilda, she take the money and run Venezuela.
Good God,
Matilda,
God.
She take the money and run.
Run away.
Oh, huh. Matilda,
yep.
She take the money and run Venezuela.
Matilda, she take the money and run Venezuela.
Matilda, she run Venezuela. Matilda, she run Venezuela. Run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela.
That gal, she run
Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela. That gal, she
run Venezuela.
That gal, she
run Venezuela.
Yes, she do.
Run Venezuela. That gal, she run Venezuela.
She sure do.
Run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela.
I want to sing this, Jamie.
Run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela.
I'll be your best friend.
You already are.
Run Venezuela, run Venezuela, run Venezuela.
That gal.
Run Venezuela.
Say
Matilda.
Oh, my Matilda.
Matilda.
Matilda, she take the money and run to Venezuela. Hold on, I tell you.
Matilda. Matilda.
One more time.
Matilda.
Bye-bye, Matilda.
Matilda.
Whoa, whoa.
Matilda, she take the money.
Everybody in my family is a singer, and I mean everybody, my mom, my dad, my sister, my grandpa, everybody sings. So I heard music literally all my life, and what made it even more special is that they all sing different kinds of music, you know, so I heard different kinds of music. I heard everything from the time I was a little kid. Okay, my mother is a white British opera singer, right? My dad is a black American jazz singer, which makes me Puerto Rican. Why not? Nah, it just gave me all the choices. You know? Gave me all the choices because I heard them all, right? In fact, our family even started because of music, because that's how my mom and dad met, through music. Let me tell you the story. World War II, my dad was in the United States Army, stationed in Europe. He was in England at the time. He was in the tank corps, okay? So one night my dad and his army buddies got together and they went to a USO show. And it happened to be the night my mom was singing. So that's how they met. My father walks in, he sits down, my mom gets up and sings an aria, and my dad fell in love. Or as he put it, he fell in love. And I always thought it was interesting because my dad spent most of his life in jazz halls, you know what I mean? And here's my mom, you know? I mean, he told me a million times, he said, you know, son, I never did like opera, but the way that woman looked, I didn't care what she was singing, right? You know, and here, my mom's like, woo, you know? Dad's like, sang it, baby. My dad was cool, he was cool. So then they danced, and they danced. and over a period of time, they fell in love, about an hour. And then they wanted to get married, okay? Now, I don't have to tell you how hard that was in the 40s. You know, it was tough. But what made it harder was that my mom was an opera singer, which meant her whole family was, but now they're gonna get married, right? So my mother has no choice. She must take my father to meet her parents. Guess who's coming to tea? Baby. And I'm proud of him. And I know that I get up here and I speak quickly because I'm into it and stuff, but I'll say it again. I am proud of them. They stayed together their whole lives, 52 years. And it wasn't easy, yeah. Thanks. It wasn't easy and I didn't help. but I wrote a song for them. This song tells their story musically, and hopefully it honors them. So on this wonderful night in Las Vegas, I offer you my mom and dad's song, Billy. And all the photographs you see are my mom and dad. She sang opera. She had tea. She met Daddy. She had me. He was jazzy. He was cool. He met my mother, and they broke the rule. She was the golden voice of England. She could have had it all, but for one emotion, she crossed the ocean and let London Bridge just fall. America was waiting. They could see the streets of gold. They put their lives in freedom's hands to watch their dreams unfold. What love had put together, let no one pull apart. America was waiting, their life was about to start. Mom was a beauty, I was cute. Dad was handsome in his army suit. People stopped, people stared, but not because of the beauty there. They heard the whispers, they heard the lies, and what they couldn't hear was oh so very clear from the look in strangers' eyes. America was waiting, but there were no streets of gold. They put their lives in freedom's hands and watched their dreams grow cold. What love had put together, hate tried to pull apart. America was waiting, waiting to break their hearts. Well, it wasn't easy those early years, but they found the laughter and they fought the fear. Someone said it, I don't recall. Maybe I read it. It said, love conquers all. That's my mom and dad. Thank you. Thank you, guys. You know what? Wait, we have a video of my mom singing. It's a short video. Would you like to see my mom sing? Yeah. Yeah. Okay, guys, roll the video, please. Roll it. There she is. My mom, but you know what? My mom's here tonight. You want to really hear her sing? Yeah? Ma, you want to sing? Come on. She's right back here. Come on. That's my mom at the age of 90. 90. Wow, look at that. Okay, sit down, Ma. What the heck am I supposed to do now? All right, just finish it. Wouldn't that sound? 90 years old, things like that. I know, it's crazy. It's crazy. And here's the deal, man. My mom sings like that at 90, and she taught me to sing, which means there's hope. That's how I look at everything, man. You know, yeah. They both taught me to sing, and I say this all the time, and it's the truth. My mom and dad. My mom taught me how to sing correctly, and my dad taught me how to enjoy it. Yeah. Yeah, I was in high school when I started, man. It was different then, you know? High school, now I care deeply about music. In high school, I didn't care about music. In high school, there was one reason I wanted to be a singer, and you know what it was. Girls, thank you, girls. I was a dork. Total dork, the dork, the dork, the dork, the dork. A, I was a dork. B, I was afraid of girls. And C, in the little town that we lived in, the only black girl in the whole school, my sister. And I hated her, so that wasn't happening, right? But I'll tell you something, though. The dork part's the worst part. That's the truth, man. Because every guy I have ever met in my life can relate to being a dork. Right, sir? I'm not picking on you, man. I'm just saying, you know? But especially in high school. In high school, if I saw a cute girl, my best line. I didn't do well. But I figured it out. I realized that because of all the music that my mom and dad had given me, if I could sing to the girls, I didn't have to try to talk to them anymore. So I got a band. So now I'm cool. Well, Friday night, I'm cool. Because now, you know, I'm up on stage, man. And now the cheerleader who ignored me all week is looking at me. You know, I mean, she's dancing with somebody else, but she's looking at me. And because of all the music, I could look right back at her, and I could turn into somebody so much cooler than myself. And when I was in high school, the coolest, most romantic singer on the planet was Johnny Mathis. Yeah. My turn. Sometimes we walk hand in hand by the sea, and we breathe in the cool, salty air. And I say to myself, it's wonderful, wonderful, oh, so wonderful, oh, my love. Okay, wait. I got one more. In the 70s, everything changed. Music changed. You know, in the 60s, you could be romantic like Perry Como and Johnny Mathis, right? But in the 70s, you had to be macho and you had to be physical. So if I wanted to try to get a girl, in the 70s, I had to try to be this guy.
on the night when I passed by your window. I saw the flickering shadow of love on the wall. She till I felt the gun in my hand, she laughed no more. Here we go. My, my, my Delilah. Why, Delilah? So before they come to break down the door, forgive me, Delilah, I just could not take.
We put together a piece to give you guys an example of all the different kinds of opera we have learned through the years. We really love singing this, so why don't we just do it? You ready,
okay,
maestro?
Yep.
Are you ready? You start in Italian.
Abra la figaro, brava bravissimo, abra la figaro, brava bravissimo, a te fortuna, a te fortuna, a te fortuna, non mancherà. Sono il facotum della città, sono il facotum della città, della città, della città, della città.
Stand a fronte a te. Stand a fronte a te.
Nighttime sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses, and you alone can make my song take flight. Help me make the music of the mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders.
great Roger Williams. Now, Roger, while I was out earlier in the show, someone yelled out, is he going to play Autumn Leaves? So I thought maybe you could just play a little bit of that. Would you mind? Amazing. You'll do well. May I have the honor of singing with you?
If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rain, smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. Smile and hide your sorrow. Smile, and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find the life is still worthwhile if you
my very special guest tonight, Mr. Roger Williams. When I was very little, my mom introduced me to Broadway. She showed me, it was a movie actually, but it was from a Broadway show. It was the first time I ever saw a Broadway show. I've seen many, many since. Still my favorite. Still, in my opinion, the best musical ever written. Maybe the best music, some of the best American pop music ever written. It was written by geniuses. This music was written by Leonard Bernstein. The lyrics are written by Stephen Sondheim. We leave you with the score, Our Suite, from West Side Story. When you're a jet all the way, from your first cigarette to your last dying day. When you're a jet, you're the swingin'est thing. Little boy, you're a man, little man, you're a king. Cool, boy. Got your rocket in your pocket. Keep it cool, boy. Real cool. Freeze it, fuzz it, easy does it. Keep it cool, boy. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good. If I can wait, I got a feeling there's a miracle doing. It's gonna come through, coming to me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good. If I can wait, come on, something, come on in. Don't be shy, be the guy. Yeah, the air is humming. Something great is coming. Come on, deliver to me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something is coming. If I can wait, it'll be there. If I can wait, it'll be there. Now it may be down the street, round the corner, just out of reach, but I know, yes I know. If I can wait, Maria, I
just met a girl named Maria, and suddenly that name will never be the same to me. Maria, I just kissed a girl named Maria. And suddenly I found how wonderful a sound can be. Maria, say it loud, and there's music playing. Play it soft, and it's almost like praying. Maria, I'll never stop saying, Maria. The most beautiful sound I've ever heard.
Let it fall back in the ocean. There's always the hurricane blowing, always the population growing, and the money owing, and the babies crying, and the bullets flying. I love the island, Manhattan. Smoke on your pipe and put that in. I like to be in America. Okay, by me in America, everything free in America,
for a small fee in America. I'd like to go back to San Juan.
I know a boat you can get on. Bye bye, so long.
Everyone there will give big cheer.
Everyone there will have moved here.
I'd like to be in America. Okay, by me in America. Everything free in America. Of course, for me in America. I'd like to be in America. Okay, by me in America. Everything free in America. Of course, for me in America.
Their way tonight. The sharks are gonna have their day tonight. They say, okay, no rumble, fair fight. But if they wanna rumble, we'll rumble them right.
Tonight, tonight. tonight, and for us, stars will stop where they are.
Your woman, forget that boy and find another. One of your own kind, stick to your own kind. A boy like that will bring you sorrow. You find another boy tomorrow. One of your own kind, stick to your own kind. A boy who kills cannot love. A boy who kills has no heart. And he's the boy who gets your love and gets your heart. Very slippery, a very smart.
Oh, no, you should know better. You were in love, or so you said. You should know better.
There's a time for us. Someday there'll be a time for us. Time together, time to spare, time to learn, time to care. Someday, somewhere, we'll find a new we'll find a way of forgiving somewhere. There's a place for us, a time and a place for us. Hold my hand, and we're halfway there. Hold my hand, I will take you there someday. I've enjoyed every minute with you.